Imagine a hidden layer of our everyday world, one that doesn't come from the exhaust of a car or the chimney of a factory. Yet, it's entwined with every wall and window around us. This unforeseen force is embodied carbon, and it's silently shaping our climate destiny with every brick laid and beam hoisted. And today, let's talk about embodied carbon. The built environment is responsible for about 40% of annual CO2 emissions. This carbon comes from two sources, embodied and operational. Most people are familiar with operational carbon, which is the carbon produced over the lifetime of a building, which could easily be 50 or more years. This includes things like lighting, heating, ventilation, cooling or air conditioning, and generating power uses throughout the building. Embodied carbon, on the other hand, is the carbon footprint of a building before it's even built. It includes emissions from extracting, manufacturing, and transporting the materials used in construction, as well as the emissions from constructing the building itself. Of that 40% of annual CO2 emissions that come from the built environment, 13% of those emissions come from upfront or embodied carbon. Only 13%. So why do we even focus on embodied carbon? Because that carbon is being released to the atmosphere now and not over the next 50 or more years. And as we strive for net zero by 2050, reducing embodied carbon is critical for our immediate impact. Besides, our energy grid is getting cleaner. Thanks to the focus on operational carbon in the past 50 years, buildings are using less energy overall, and the energy they are using is coming from cleaner sources. In other words, the impact of operational carbon is being reduced, and therefore embodied carbon is playing an increasingly significant role in the decarbonization of our built environment. Okay, Steven, we got it. We have to reduce embodied carbon. But how? I am glad you asked. First of all, don't build new. But that's a topic for another video. There are a number of ways to reduce embodied carbon, including using low-carbon building materials, such as recycled materials or renewable materials like wood, designing energy-efficient buildings, building for durability, or minimizing waste. However, the most important and holistic approach is employing life cycle assessment to ascertain and diminish your building's carbon footprint. And that's a topic for our next video. Check it out here. If you find this video helpful, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe to our YouTube channel. See you later.